Upon receiving a read data by periodic identifier request, other than stop sending request, server shall check whether the conditions are correct to execute the service. If the conditions are correct, then the server shall transmit a positive response message, including the service identifier. In the last video, we had a look into details of read memory by address 23 service. Let's have a look into next diagnostic service, that's read data by periodic identifier 2A service. Before we dive in, let's first understand the purpose of this service. Read data by periodic identifier service allows the client to request the periodic transmission of data record values from the server identified by one or more periodic record data identifier. The data record can include analog input and output signals, digital input and output signals, internal data, system status, etc. The client request message can contain more than one periodic data identifiers that defines the data record maintained by the server. Hex value of F200 till F2FF is the range reserved for periodic record data identifier, and the periodic data identifier in the request is defined by the lowest bytes of the periodic record data identifier. The format and definition of the data record shall be vehicle manufacturer specific. The request shall contain transmission mode, which defines the periodic transmission rate of the message, that is the time between any two consecutive response message to the same periodic data identifier. A periodic data identifier can support only one transmission mode at a given time. A change to the schedule of the periodic data identifier shall be performed on reception of the request message with a new transmission mode value. Multiple schedules for different periodic data identifier shall be supported upon vehicle manufacturer's request. Upon receiving a read data by periodic identifier request, other than stop sending request, server shall check whether the conditions are correct to execute the service. If the conditions are correct, then the server shall transmit a positive response message, including the service identifier. Following which, the server shall access the data elements of the records specified by the periodic data identifier parameter and transmit their values in separate periodic data response message for each periodic data identifier containing the associated data record parameters. The server shall never transmit a negative response message once it has accepted the initial request message by responding positively. With this understanding, let's dive into the request definition of the service. Firstly, we have read data by periodic identifier request SID, which maps to value 2A, followed by transmission mode, which can take values from 0 to FF. Value 0, phi to FF are reserved by ISO SAE. Value 1, which indicates send at low rate. Sending this value in the request configures the server to transmit the requested read data by periodic identifier at a slow rate. Slow rate is defined in the server as specified by vehicle manufacturer. Similarly, we have value 2 and 3, send at medium rate and send at fast rate respectively. Sending the value in the request configures the server to transmit the requested read data by periodic identifier at a medium rate or fast rate respectively. Medium and fast rate is defined in the server as specified by vehicle manufacturer. Value 4, which indicates stop sending. Sending this value in the request stops the server from transmitting periodic response messages for the data identifier. Coming to our next parameter, which is periodic data identifier. This parameter defines the server data record that are being requested by the client. It shall be possible to request multiple periodic data identifier with a single request, that's from 1 to m. Let's look into the positive response. There are two sets of positive response for the request. One is the initial positive response, which indicates the acceptance of the server request. Secondly, subsequent periodic data response message sent periodically as requested by the read data by periodic identifier request. Let's first look into the initial positive response format. This positive response shall only contain read data by periodic identifier response SID, which is value 6A, indicating the acceptance of read data by periodic identifier request. Let's have a look into the format of the periodic data response message. This positive response shall contain first the periodic data identifier, which is similar to periodic data identifier sent in the request, followed by the data record parameter, which contains the data record requested by the client periodically. The content of the data record is vehicle manufacturer specific. Going further, let's have a look into the negative response. Following are the negative response supported by the service. NRC 13, that's incorrect message length or invalid format. This NRC shall be sent if the length of the requested message is invalid or the client exceeds the maximum number of periodic data identifiers allowed to request at a time. NRC 22, condition not correct. This NRC shall be sent if the operating conditions of the server are not met to perform the required actions. For example, if the client requests periodic data identifier with different transmission modes and the server does not support multiple transmission modes simultaneously, then the NRC 22 shall be sent. NRC 31, that is request out of range. This NRC shall be sent if none of the requested periodic data identifier values are supported by the device, or if none of the requested periodic data identifier values are supported by the current session, or if the specified transmission mode is not supported by the device, or if the client exceeds the maximum number of periodic data identifier allowed to be scheduled concurrently. Lastly, we have NRC 33, which is security access denied. This NRC shall be sent if at least one of the periodic data identifier is secured and the server is not in an unlocked state. Diagram shows the order of evaluation of different NRCs. Firstly, we have the NRC 13 check for minimum and maximum length of the request, followed by transmission mode support check, which if fails would lead to NRC 31. Next, there is a check to see if the scheduler is free, which if fails leads to NRC 31 again, followed by a check on security to confirm if the secure access is required for the service or if the ECU has write access. In case if this check fails, would lead to NRC 33, followed by check on the fulfillment of precondition before executing the service, which if fails would lead to NRC 22. Followed by two more checks, one on the support of at least one DID requested in the current active session. Secondly, a check to see if scheduler is free to support all the DIDs requested. If either one of these fail, then NRC 31 shall be sent. If all the above checks are through, then positive response for the service requested shall be sent. Now, let's try to understand read data by periodic identifier with an example. Let's assume the client requests two DIDs, E4 and 23 respectively, to read periodically at medium rate. The client shall send the request as follows, with the transmission mode set to 2. Server shall send the initial positive response as follows, and then the server shall send the periodic positive response for DID E4 as follows, and DID 2-3 as follows. In case if the client wants to stop the periodic transmission of DID E4, the client shall send the request message as follows, where the transmission mode is set to 4. Server shall send the initial positive response as follows. With this, we had a detailed look into read data by periodic identifier to a service. In upcoming session, we'll have a look into the write data by identifier to e-service. Thank you.